I really have no intro for this. Cursed poems, cursed flash animations, cursed dreams, cursed mirrors, and a whole slew of demons. But after all, they're just stories. They can't hurt you, right? These are the top 40 creepiest Japanese urban legends. Girl from the Gap. The girl from the Gap is a spirit living in gaps or cracks in houses, such as in between furniture, doors, or drawers. She appears mostly as a slim female of unknown age, and will often make their target feel like there's someone there, watching them from a distance. According to the spirit, if one day you were to see her, she will ask you to play hide and seek before disappearing off. The second time you see her eyes within a gap, she will take you to hell or another dimension.
10 Dreams. The legend of the 10 days of dreams goes like this. You will dream for 10 days in succession. Each dream comes with a rule you must follow. Warning. If you hear this story, you might begin having the same dreams starting within 3 days. If you'd like to avoid this story, skip to here. First day. You will dream that you are sleeping in your room. Then you will notice a girl peeping through the window. First rule, you must let the girl in. Second day. The girl is inside your room. She's looking downward and you cannot see her face because of her long hair. She is muttering something. After a while, you realize she is saying, "Please, please." Second rule, let her come into the bed and lie down next to you. Third day, you and the girl are lying side by side. You are now able to see the girl's face. Her face is horribly burnt. Third rule, do not cry out when you see her face. Fourth day, you get out of the bed. The girl says, "Let's go to the park." Fourth rule. Take the girl to the nearest park without saying a word. Fifth day. When you arrive at the park, you will notice someone pushing a stroller. Look closely, and you will notice that the mother is a cat and the baby is a dog. Fifth rule. You must kill either one of them. Sixth day. While you are playing with the girl in the park, you will see an airship about to take off. Sixth rule. Make sure you get on the airship in time. Seventh day. The airship is full of people who, just like you, have heard this story. Seventh rule. Find a seat for yourself at any cost. Eighth day. After some time, red roses and black roses start raining down on you. Eighth rule. Throw out only the black roses from the airship. Ninth day. The airship takes you back to the park. Ninth rule. Go home with the girl and lie down in the bed again. The 10th day. You will not know what happens on the 10th day unless you have observed all of the rules from the previous days. You should also tell this story to someone while you are awake. Otherwise, you will go back to the first day of the dream.
The manhole. The urban legend surrounding this manhole was about a girl named Mayumi. One day, when she was walking towards her all-girls school, she saw another girl, a fellow classmate, who was often bullied. Bullying could often get extreme at these all-girls schools, like Mayumi's, and she did not want to be the odd one out, so she bullied the girl along with the rest of the class. She remembered saying cruel things to this poor woman. Mayumi once saw the girl was jumping on a manhole. 9, 9, 9, 9, the girl kept muttering while she jumped. Mayumi asked the girl what the hell she was doing, but got ignored. Angered, she pushed the girl away and stood on the manhole herself. At the exact moment she did this, the girl who had been pushed away, quickly using all her strength, removed the lid on the manhole. Mayumi fell right into it. The girl put the lid back on and was smiling with satisfaction. She started jumping again, this time muttering, 10, 10, 10.
Shirokiya Department Store Deaths. In 1932, the Shirokiya Department Store in Tokyo was caught in a massive fire, tragically taking the lives of 14 people. The legend goes that several female shop assistants managed to get to the roof of the building. Firefighters urged them to climb down the safety ropes. The women did so, but at the halfway point, a strong gust of wind came along. All of the women were wearing kimonos, a traditional Japanese garment that required no underwear. The women, fearing that the wind would expose them in front of the growing audience below, let go of the rope to cover themselves, causing them to fall to their deaths. Strangely enough, the department has recently urged women to wear underwear within work hours. This story has even been documented in Japanese firefighting manuals.
Oiwa. As one of the most popular stories told in Japan, the Oiwa is a spirit of a young woman who once lived in a small town. And despite the fact that her husband was very poor, the two lived happily together for some time. But soon, the husband began to grow depressed and angry for not being able to support his wife financially. He begins to have an affair with a different woman with a more financially successful father who offered him help. So the husband devises a plan to kill his wife Oiwa and their unborn child by pushing her off the ledge of a cliff. He gave her the best funeral he could afford, seeing that his money problems would soon be gone. However, Oiwa returned as a spirit with a disfigured face, growling at him, betrayal. She chased him all the way towards the same cliff, until he jumped off, killing himself.
Sadako. When Sadako Yamamura was a young girl, her mother was believed to be a psychic after performing numerous experiments with Dr. Akuma. The doctor eventually convinces her mother to publicly display her psychic abilities, but she couldn't, and was labeled a fraud. Distraught, the mother commits suicide, and Sadako is left living with her father, having inherited her mother's psychic abilities. At 19 years old, Sadako attends an acting troupe, where she meets and falls in love with a sound director, a man named Hiroshi. However, a strange and deadly curse develops in the form of an audio tape, killing members of the acting troupe. Concerned, she tries to meet up with Dr. Akuma, only to be assaulted and nearly killed by a different man named Nagao. Sadako fights back with her psychic abilities, but Nagao overpowers her and throws her into a well. She swears vengeance on the world before dying, her hatred and anger manifesting into a terrible curse.
Fatal Fare. The legend is about a taxi driver who picks up a stranger in the middle of the night. The stranger takes the back seat and asks the taxi driver to take him to an unheard destination. He gives strange instructions and complex directions. that often leads to dark alleys or dead-end streets. This continues on and on until the taxi driver finally gets aggravated enough to turn back to face his client. However, when he does, the stranger is no longer there. Confused, the taxi driver fails to realize that the car he is driving is about to drive off a cliff. By the time he realizes, it'll all be too late.
8 feet tall. Hachi Shakusama, or simply known as 8 feet tall, is a woman who wanders around abducting children. It takes on the appearance of an extremely tall woman and often makes the sound, pull, 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 in a deep male voice. It'll appear differently depending on who sees it. Some say it looks like a haggard old woman in a kimono, while others say it's a girl in a white funeral shroud. She always chooses children as her victims, since they are dependent on their parents, making it easier for her to appear as just a relative.
Double bed. According to the legend, if you're sleeping alone, you should never sleep in a double bed. If you do, try never to sleep on just one side. Otherwise, the legend goes, in the dark of the night, while you are sleeping on one side, something or someone will lie down on the floor next to the bed and start sleeping. You will hear deep breathing as you and this ghost or apparition sleep. If you do not get rid of this ghost later, it will get up and lay next to you in bed. The deep breathing sound will be right next to you. If you do not rid the ghost this time, next time the ghost will enter and sit down on the bed while you sleep. You'll feel the bed shake. Then the mattress will start bouncing because the ghost will start jumping up and down on the mattress. And then... sweet dreams.
Kunikuni. The Kunikuni is described as a long, paper-thin, white apparition who is sometimes seen on countrysides or in large open fields. Its limbs permanently sway and wiggle as if there was a strong gust of wind, which is actually where the creature gets its name, Kunikuni being Japanese for to wiggle or to twist. The first appearance of the Kunikuni was on multiple online Japanese websites in 2003, similar to that of the Slender Man legend. Likewise, people began citing their own encounters with the monster, posting stories and eyewitness accounts online. It can apparently only be seen from a distance, but looking directly at it is said to cause insanity upon the viewer.
Kashima Reiko. Warning. According to the legend, after hearing this story, Kashima Reiko will appear to you within a month. If you want to move on to the next one, you may skip to this time. Kashima Reiko was once a woman who lived in the island of Hokkaido, Japan. However, she was brutally attacked by a group of men who left her for dead. No one came to help her. She was crawling for help, but collapsed on railroad tracks before a train came and sliced her in two. Her body was severed from the waist down. Now she wanders the nights looking for her legs, appearing in schools or in people's homes. If you see her, she will ask, "Where are my legs?" The answer is, on the Meishin Expressway. She'll reply with, "Who told you that?" To which you must say, "Kashima Reiko told me that." Sometimes she'll ask, "What's my name?" Do not reply with Kashima Reiko, or else she will kill you. Instead, reply with, "Mask Death Demon," as that is what Kashima translates to. If successful, she'll crawl away to ask another victim.
Hikio-san. Hikyo-san is a story of a young schoolgirl who is often the target of bullying. Students would write very hurtful comments on her desk and backpack. They would damage her shoes, make her fall on the road, and just bully her in many other ways. At home, her family yelled at her and hit her frequently. Nobody would stand up for her. They were all afraid of becoming the next target. The constant bullying took on a new toll on her physical appearance. As revenge, she's said to scare and capture students from elementary schools and drag them on the floor until they are badly mutilated. The Japanese film of the same name is based on her and on these events.
Cowhead. The Cowhead story is apparently so morbidly horrifying, so frightening, that whoever manages to listen to the complete story will experience fright and nightmares for days. Some theories about its origins are floating around, the most common being that it was discovered in the 17th century. Nobody knows for sure what the story is about. It was rumored to be an unpublished piece from sci-fi writer Sakio Komatsu, but there is no evidence to link the author to the legend. A Ukrainian folktale called Cow's Head does exist, as well as a 2003 film called Gozu, directed by Takashi Mike, but neither of them are connected to the urban legend.
Anako-san. Anako-san is the spirit of a small girl in a red skirt who is believed to possess the girls' washrooms in all the schools in Japan. The legend goes that if a person approaches the third stall in the girls' restroom, knocks three times and asks, "Are you there, Anako-san?" a voice will be heard saying, "I am here." You then have the choice of either walking away or opening the door. If you choose to open the door, she'll either be there waiting for you before vanishing or violently drag you into the toilet and kill you.
No face. No perabo, or no face, is a Japanese creature known primarily for frightening humans, but are usually otherwise harmless. They are often encountered during the night in rural, deserted areas. They appear to the victim as an ordinary human, or sometimes a person they're familiar with. Then, after waiting for the right time, their facial features will disappear, leaving a blank patch of skin where their face should be. No face has no real agenda or interest in killing people. They are just mischievous spirits who like giving wanderers a good scare. On May 19th, 1959, reporter Bob Krause reported a witness confronting a woman with a featureless blank face in the woman's restroom. Although the witness was sent to the hospital after suffering a nervous breakdown, she survived and was able to give more details. The creature she encountered was later revealed to be a noperabo.
The Human Pillar. As a form of sacrifice, when people were to commit suicide, their bodies would be encased within buildings, becoming guardians of said buildings. This practice was known as Hitobashira, and the most famous example is the Matsui Castle. The castle was built in the 17th century, with several walls falling down. As a result, a human sacrifice was sought to steady the structure. Train drivers have reported hearing ghostly noises under the tunnel, which is believed to be the screams of those who were buried in the walls.
The Snake Woman. This urban legend is about a large, snake-like creature with the head of a woman, who lurks in shallow pools of water as she preys on fishermen and swimmers. She will paralyze her victims with her eyes and use her tongue to drain you of your blood. In some stories, she can be seen washing her long black hair on shore and will react violently to those who bother her. In other cases, she carries a small, but extremely heavy, childlike bundle, which she uses to trap her victims from fleeing. Despite her size, she is well hidden strong and very fast. Your best chance of staying safe is to avoid walking alone near the beach at night.
Purple Mirror. The story of the Purple Mirror is about a cursed phrase that will kill anyone who still remembers it by age 20. If you'd like to avoid listening to the story, you may go to the time displayed on the screen to skip straight to the next legend. Years ago, a young Japanese girl was given a mirror by her parents. She loved the mirror so much that she would look at herself with it every day. She was desperate to look beautiful, to the point of developing anorexia. She became painfully thin and frail, but whenever she looked into her mirror, she saw herself as beautiful. One day while painting her mirror purple, she began to see who she really was through her reflection, and she was mortified. She hated the way she looked, and she broke her mirror. On her 20th birthday, she was preparing for her big birthday when she was struck by a car and killed. As she laid there dying, her last words were, "Purple mirror, purple mirror, purple mirror." After the funeral, her parents searched her room and discovered that her broken mirror was gone. Rumors began to spread. Some who attended her funeral died under mysterious circumstances. Since then, the phrase "purple mirror" is cursed, and whoever remembers it by their 20th birthday will die.
Gnoll mask. The gnoll mask is a mask used to represent a jealous female demon or serpent. They are secured by the wealthy for safety and are mainly used for operas. However, they come with a strange legend that if the mask were to be worn, it will absorb all the negative energy of its host, including anger, hatred, jealousy, and so on. The gnoll mask is said to be constantly persuading its owner to wear it, consuming more and more of its negative energy until the owner begins to rot. Once the owner succumbs to the mask's power, it leaves to find a new host.
Futakuchi Ona. A Futakuchi Ona, or the Two-Mouth Woman, is a terrifying creature in Japanese folklore. They look almost identical to regular women, except that the back of their head splits apart, forming lips, teeth, and essentially creating a large, functioning mouth. The mouth is said to have a mind of its own, consuming large amounts of food to sustain its host. However, it will whisper spiteful and menacing threats to her, demanding food and causing great pain to the woman. If not fed, the mouth will screech unbearably loud until it gets what it wants, even going so far as to use her hair as serpents or tentacles to grab nearby food. The legend originated as a curse or a supernatural disease linked to women who eat very little, as if saying this would happen to them if they didn't nourish themselves properly. One story involves a man who was so poor, he could barely afford to buy himself enough to eat. Fortunately, his wife ate very little, so he didn't have to spend that much money on food. However, the little food he did have began to strangely disappear at night. It's later revealed that his wife has a large, grotesque mouth on the back of her head, which reveals itself when she unbounds her hair. And to his horror, he tried to escape, but the woman's hair, now acting as tentacles, strangles the man to near death. He manages to escape, and the two disappear, going their separate ways, never to meet again.
Himuro Mansion. According to legend, this large mansion exists somewhere on the outskirts of Tokyo. The Himuro family resided within the mansion and lived by a certain ritual called the strangling ritual. This involved keeping a girl locked up and completely abstinent from society. Every 50 years, the Himuro family would tie ropes around the girl's neck and limbs, only to pull her apart. The bloody ropes are then said to protect the family from bad karma until the next ceremonial practice. However, one year, the girl captive managed to look out a window and fell in love with a nearby boy. This nullified the ritual, and as soon as the father of the family found out, He went insane. He felt the only way to save his family was to kill them all, pleading that the afterlife is safer than what's to come. The father then ends his own life. No one's quite sure what bad karma would have happened if the ritual didn't work. However, the sight interested the people of Tokyo, and many reported seeing strange phenomena at the Himuro mansion, such as bloody handprints and nooses. Some say that taking a picture of the window will reveal the ghostly image of a young girl behind it. A total of 7 strange deaths have occurred at the mansion, other than the Himuro family, and to this day remain completely unexplainable. The game Fatal Frame is said to be based on the legend of the Himuro mansion.
Kayeko. Appearing in the Grudge movies and in the Japanese horror film series, Ju-on, Kayeko was an ordinary person. As a child, she was often left alone and neglected by her parents. Classmates at school would describe her as creepy or weird. In college, after the death of her parents, which didn't affect Kayeko in the slightest, she met the love of her life, a man named Taeko. They eventually got married and had a son together. A few years later, Kayeko falls in love with her son's teacher. She begins to express her feelings towards him in her journal. Her husband, Taeko, eventually discovers and reads the journal, shocked that his wife might be cheating, or worse, that their child might not be his. He violently attacks Kayeko, eventually snapping her neck and crushing her throat. She survived but was left paralyzed, only able to make an eerie moaning sound. Kayeko died shortly after, and becomes an onryo, Japanese for a vengeful spirit, due to the violent nature of her death. Taeko travels to the teacher's house, killing him and his pregnant wife as well. And on the way back, Taeko confronts the vengeful spirit of his now deceased wife, Kayeko, and she kills him. Now the house they lived in is believed to be haunted by the spirits of the teacher, Taeko, and Kayeko herself, sometimes making the same faint moaning noise she would right before death.
The Red Cloak. The Red Cloak is a legend that goes by many names. Red Vest, Red Cape, Red Mantle, and so on. They all involve the spirit of a masked man who wears such a cape, haunting public restrooms or, in some versions, primarily women's restrooms. He is said to be handsome or charming, thus wearing a mask to hide his face. If a person were to use the last stall in a bathroom that was haunted by the Red Cloak, he will ask if you want red paper or blue paper. According to who's telling the story, there are a number of outcomes to whatever you answer with. If you answer with red paper, you will either have your throat, head, or hands sliced off until you bleed to death, creating a sort of red cloak with your blood. If you answer with blue paper, you will be violently strangled until your face turns blue. If you're absolutely insane enough, you can answer with yellow paper and have your head forcefully shoved into the toilet you were using. But you will survive. If you don't answer at all, the spirit will simply depart, and asking for a different color or attempting to outsmart the spirit will result in you being dragged to the underworld, the realm of departed souls, sometimes referred to as Yomi.
The Kiyotaki Tunnel. This tunnel was built in 1927 and is supposedly haunted by the workers who died from working there. The workers were pretty much treated like slaves and built a tunnel under harsh conditions. The tunnel is exactly 444 meters long, 4 being an extremely unlucky number in Japan. People report that spirits of the workers can be seen in this tunnel at night. In some cases, they can be seen sitting in the passenger seats within the cars passing by. There's also a mirror inside the tunnel, and if you were to look inside it, you would see a ghost by your reflection. And supposedly, you would die very, very soon.
Kakuri-san. Similar to a Ouija board, Kakuri-san is one of the most famous games in Japan. Mostly played by school children, the game is played to summon spirits and ask them questions. The game, however, isn't as dangerous as the Ouija board, since the spirit summon, whom the game is named after, is a lot more calm and less dangerous. To play Kakuri-san, you need at least two people, a sheet of paper, a pen, and a coin. Take a blank sheet of paper and draw Tori, a traditional Japanese gate, at the top in red ink. Write yes and no on either side of the Tori. Beneath this, write one row of numbers from 0 to 9 and three rows of letters from A to Z. Open a window or a door so that Kakuri-san will be able to enter the room. Place a coin on the Tori. Each person places their index finger on the coin. Call the spirit by saying, Kakuri-san, Kakuri-san, if you're here, please move this coin. You can ask Kakuri-san whatever question you'd like. It will move the coin to spell out the answer. To end the game, you must ask Kakuri-san to leave by saying, Kakuri-san, Kakuri-san, please return home. The coin will move to yes, and then come to a rest on the red Tori. When you are certain Kakuri-san has left, you must destroy the paper. Either tear it to pieces or burn it. You must also spend the coin you used before the end of the next day. Although Kakuri-san is not as dangerous as the Ouija board, it still is not recommended that you play it. Many people can become upset and depressed if they receive answers they do not like. Also, always remember that Kakuri-san is a trickster spirit and can easily lie to you.
Tenomi, also known as the Pale Man. Tenomi is the spirit of an old blind man who was brutally assaulted and killed one night by robbers. Before his death, he lashed out in anger, yelling about how he could have defended myself if only he could see. Because he didn't get to die in peace, his spirit has returned as a wrathful spirit with eyes on the palms of his hands. Despite this, he is still relatively blind. He can only see by the openings in his palms, and he only can see further by pointing said palms towards his target. Now he roams through the cities and villages in search of the robbers that attacked him. Since he didn't see their faces in the first place, Tenomi will simply kill anyone who comes by his way.
The Slit Mouth Woman. This urban legend warns about the dangers of walking alone at night, for they might encounter the Slit Mouth Woman. She wears a surgical mask covering her mouth, which is a common sight in Japan, as people wear them to protect others from the spread of disease or bacteria. But this woman will stop wandering children and ask, "Am I beautiful?" If they responded with no, she kills them with a pair of scissors she always carries around. If instead they respond with yes, the woman removes her mask to reveal her mouth has been slit from ear to ear. She'll then ask, "How about now?" No matter what the response, the slit mouth woman will kill them. If they say no, they are cut in half. And if they say yes, she cuts their mouths to be exactly like hers. Thankfully, there are a few ways to escape. At this point, if you were to instead respond with, "You're average, so-so," or even another question like, "Am I pretty?" she'll get confused, and you'll have the chance to run.
Cursed Kleenex commercial. In the 1980s, Kleenex released a Japanese commercial featuring a woman dressed in all white and a young child dressed as a Japanese ogre. Many viewers found the advertisement disturbing. Some complained that the song sounded like a German curse, despite the lyrics being in English. Because of this, several rumors began to circulate about the cast. According to the legend, the entire crew met their untimely death through accidents, and the lead actress, Kiko Matsuzaka, became pregnant with a demon child. Some believe that the commercial will change if viewed during midnight.
Kisaragi Station. In 2004, an anonymous post was made in the middle of a thread called Posts About Strange Occurrences Around You, Thread 26. The story goes that a man named Hasumi was on a train to work, but the train hasn't stopped at a station for the past 20 minutes. It usually stops every 5 minutes, and everyone on board is sleeping. This was odd. So he posted online for comfort. He finally arrived at an unheard location called the Kisaragi Station. The other users on the forum have never heard of this location, and neither has Asumi. It seemed completely abandoned, and there were no taxis at sight. He wandered for about 20 minutes and called his parents and the police. His parents couldn't find any information on the place, and the police thought this was some prank. Frightened, Hasumi ran back the way he came, through a tunnel to try and find something, and he eventually came across someone who called for a train and take Hasumi to the nearest location, a hotel in Hina. As the train went up the mountains, Hasumi's phone battery was dying, and his final post was made. He wasn't heard from again.
Dream School. This story is about an endless dream one boy has, which he cannot escape from. This story is cursed, and will cause whoever to learn about it to be trapped within the same dream in a week or so. If you don't want to listen to this story, you may skip to this time. Anyways, the story goes that this young boy had a dream about being in a school he was unfamiliar with. He ran through the hallways, up the stairs, and turned at every corner, but to no avail. Sometimes he would find himself back where he started from, despite running in a straight line. Other times he would swear he's on the third floor, but after going up the stairs, he ended up back on the first floor. This didn't make sense. When, out of nowhere, the boy heard something in the distance. It sounded like footsteps. They grew louder and louder. The boy ran as fast as he can, thankfully finding an emergency exit. However, the door was locked and the glass box that contained the key was smashed in. The key wasn't there, but instead a note saying that it was in classroom 108. The footsteps sounded closer and closer. The boy made it to classroom 108 and searched frantically for the keys. At this point, the footsteps were right in front of the door, and there was heavy knocking. Just then, the knocking stopped. There was a cold silence. The boy managed to work up the courage to open the door. What he saw horrified him. It was several boys and girls, all cut up into pieces. The floor completely drenched in blood. The boy ran off. He couldn't take it anymore.
Okiku's doll. The legend goes that a young boy bought a doll for his 2-year-old sister named Okiku. She loved a doll. She would play with it every day. Unfortunately, the little girl died at a very young age. Strangely enough, the doll's hair continued to grow. The parents believe this was because the spirit of their daughter resided in the doll. Since 1938, the parents decided to hand the doll over to the Manenji Temple. No scientific or theoretical explanation for why the doll can grow hair has been given. It remains a mystery to this day.
Inunaki Village. The Inunaki Village is a mysterious location that is completely isolated from the rest of Japan, creating a lot of doubt as to whether or not it really exists. According to the legend, the village's entrance has a sign saying, "The constitutional laws of Japan do not apply here." And those who say they visited the area reported seeing people commit incest, cannibalism, and murder on a daily basis. For some reason, electronic devices do not work here, and many people who have traveled to find this village have never returned home.
Rokorokubi. Also known as Long Neck, these Japanese women are said to look almost completely human. And for the most part, they live their lives as ordinary normal people. The only difference, of course, being their disturbingly long neck, which only extends to great lengths while they are asleep. It will sneak out the window late at night, preying on small animals or scaring nearby townsfolk. The morning after, the woman will wake up with stretch marks on their neck. The second version of Rokorokubi are the Nukikubai, also known as the removable head woman, whose heads instead come completely off and float around at night. They're much more dangerous than their aforementioned counterpart, actually killing their victims and drinking their blood like some misshapen vampire. However, these can be killed if their bodies are discovered without the head.
Satoru-kun. Satoru-kun is an urban legend about a game that people play to find out the answer to any question they have. According to the legend, Satoru-kun is an all-knowing Japanese ghost, spirit, or even demon who will appear to you as a young boy. In order to summon him, the following ritual must be performed. First, you need a cell phone, some coins, and a public payphone. Step 1. Insert the money into the public phone box. Dial your own mobile phone number. Step 2. Repeat the following chant. Satoru-kun. Satoru-kun, please come here. Satoru. Satoru, please show yourself. Satoru. Satoru, please answer me if you are there. If everything is done right, you will receive several phone calls from Satoru-kun, and he will tell you that he is getting closer and closer to you. The last time he calls, he will say, "I am behind you now." This is when you ask your question. Rules: do not turn around or try to look at Satoru-kun. Do not touch him. Do not call him if you do not have a question to ask. When he is behind you, do not delay. Ask the question immediately. If you break any of these rules, Satoru-kun will drag you to hell.
Teke Teke. The Teke Teke is the spirit of a woman who was severed in half by a subway train. It's unknown whether she fell off by mere accident or purposefully as a form of suicide. Regardless, after the bottom half of her body fell right onto the tracks, the oncoming subway train violently ran her over at the waist, splitting her into two. Shortly after dying, her spirit manifested in the form of just a torso, dragging what's left of her with her two claw-like hands, creating a teke, teke, teke sound as she moves. A popular story surrounding this urban legend involves a young schoolboy encountering a beautiful girl staring at him from a window. Although he was confused because this was an all-boys school, he didn't mind. The two smiled and waved at each other. Then, the girl leaped out of the window, revealing herself as the Teke Teke. The boy, frightened by the fact that she's missing half her body, wanted to run away in panic. But before he could, the spirit pulled out a scythe and sliced him in half, mimicking her own disfigurement.
Yuki Onna. A popular figure in Japanese literature and film, the Yuki Onna is the spirit of a beautiful woman with long black hair and cold blue lips. She's known by many different names, but is most commonly referred to as the Snow Woman. Naturally, she only appears in snowy or misty nights, sometimes wearing a white kimono or in some cases, completely nude. She'll misguide wandering travelers into harsh snowstorms, killing them. Other stories describe her murderous tactics as more ruthless, breaking into homes or freezing people to death herself. Her pale and, at times, transparent body makes her difficult to see in snow, with the exception of her face and hair. Also, she's said to float above the ground, leaving no footsteps behind. Some legends even say that she has no legs or feet at all, and if threatened, she can disappear into the mist and not be seen again.
The Red Room. The story of the Red Room is an internet urban legend about a pop-up that appears on a person's computer. The pop-up shows a red door and a voice asks, "Do you like?" It cannot be closed, and will simply keep reappearing until finally asking, "Do you like the Red Room?" Clicking the link will also send you through a series of questions before reaching the end, and you will find your name listed within the game. The next day, you will be found dead, and the walls in your house will be painted with your own blood. In 2004, an 11-year-old girl, known as Girl A online, killed her 12-year-old best friend, seemingly out of nowhere. The murder involved slitting the victim's throat and arms with a utility knife. When the police investigated her home, they found the Red Room video bookmarked on her computer.
Suicidal Japanese Drawing. Shortly before a teenage girl committed suicide, she drew a picture, scanned it, and posted it online. The picture is supposedly haunted by the girl's damaged spirit, provoking feelings of sadness and despair. According to legend, the viewer gets drawn to the girl's blue eyes. Others swear they can sense her suicidal feelings of anger and sadness within them. The scariest part is that some say it's hard to stare directly into the drawing for longer than 5 minutes. There are reports of people taking their own lives after trying to do so. It is believed that the picture changes as you view it. There is a hint of a growing taunting smirk appearing on the girl's lips, or a dark ring glow around the girl or her eyes.
The Video Will. This story details the death of a man named Kai, who tragically slipped and fell while free climbing. About half a year before his death, Kai asked his closest friend for a favor. Kai knew his hobby was dangerous, and that he couldn't predict if something would go wrong. So he asked his closest friend if he would help him record a video message to be shown to his family, in case something did go wrong. The friend accepted, and the message goes as follows.
"This is Kai. If you're watching this, then it means that I'm already dead. Koriyami, thank you for all that you've done, and I am sorry for all the trouble that I caused due to my hobby. My parents who raised me and all my friends, you guys are probably sad because I'm dead. Well, don't be. I'm in heaven and I'm very happy. I'm sorry that I couldn't meet with you guys for real, but I swear while this message plays, I'll be watching you in heaven. Ami, Your dad is watching you from heaven, so please, don't be sad. But instead, smile for me. Until? Goodbye.
After Kai's untimely death, the best friend played the video for his family at the funeral. However, there was a whirling sound and a black screen that continued for about 10 seconds. The friend was confused, and as soon as he approached the VHR, Kai's form began to show in the middle of the black screen behind a dark background. The video is distorted and hard to hear without a static. The whole family was in an uproar with Kai's wife demanding to know what the hell happened. The friend apologized and took the DVD to a shrine to destroy it. The priest saw the envelope containing the DVD and he said, sorry. It's too much for this place. According to him, the moment Kai recorded a video, he was being dragged down to hell. The priest didn't even understand why Kai managed to live half a year longer, when he should have been dead right after that recording.
Tomino's Hell. Tomino's Hell is a cursed Japanese poem that causes illness, misfortune, or even death to whoever reads it out loud. Many have reported feeling uneasy after reading just halfway into it. The poem is about a Tomino who dies and falls to hell. It was written by Yomoto Inuiko, in a story titled, The Heart is Like a Rolling Stone. The poem with English subtitles goes something like this.
Tomino